Namaste viewers, welcome to the channel Bloom Skills. In today's video, let us see the different types of questioning using the Bloom's taxonomy. Already in our channel, I have uploaded a video on basics of Bloom's taxonomy, like how we have to frame the questions and on what basis and what are the different criteria under the Bloom's taxonomy. As it was requested to elaborate on the questioning pattern, I have brought this video to your notice. So now, first let us see why the Bloom's taxonomy is important. In any type of questioning to the students, in any form of questioning put forth for the learners, but why a question is put forth in the class. You know, the basis of Bloom taxonomy, it is to write the learning objectives or to plan your curriculum to develop students' higher thinking skills. That is, we generally come across a term called HALS. That is nothing but higher thinking skills, or to incorporate knowledge to be learned effectively. So what is Bloom's taxonomy and its purpose? It is a classification system which is used to define or distinguish different level of human cognition. That is, their thinking, their learning and understanding. So what is this Bloom taxonomy theory? Bloom's taxonomy theory is nothing but which we call it as Bloom taxonomy. This framework has been applied by generations of teachers and college instructors in their teaching loop. The framework elaborated by Bloom and his collaborators consisted of six major categories. That is, remembering, understanding, applying, analyzing, evaluating, and creating. Let us today, briefly in this video, understand how a questioning skill under each category has to be. So when I'm talking about remembering, what is remembering? To recall a relevant knowledge from a long-term memory. What is meant by the term understanding? To make sense of something what you learned. What you learn, you understand about that. So what is meant by the term applying? Applying is you have a knowledge, you use the knowledge to apply somewhere or to gain in a new ways. What is meant by analyzing? Analyzing is breaking the concept into parts and understand how each part is related to one another. So what is meant by the term evaluating? Making judgments based on a set of guidelines, or I can say it is as rules. What is all these objectives is all about? Creating is nothing but you put an information together in an innovative way, in a creative way. So now let us see about each domain individually, and I will also tell you some example question under each domain. So when I'm talking about remembering, how a remembering question has to be. So whenever a teacher teaches in the class, they have to analyze the student, or they have to think whether the learning objective or the learning outcome has been reached. After your teaching, every teacher has to understand or check whether the learning outcome for a learner has reached. Yes. The remembering is at the basic level and to the creative level. Only after understanding, after recall their knowledge or the content what they have learned, they can come across these steps under the Bloom's taxonomy. We can analyze or we can test the learners only after they understand the concept what is taught in the class. So let us see, in all the level, it can be a primary level or it can be a secondary or it can be in higher level. In any base level, if you see, in any level of students, or in any level of learners, the way we ask the questions or the Bloom's taxonomy can be applied. Only the questioning pattern or the content knowledge, we have to take it as age appropriate. Say for example, under remembering concept, if I say remembering, I can say this is a recall of your previously learned content. It usually involves a wide range of general knowledge and does not focus in on a specific area. Most questions in this section involve the lower order thinking because they are just simple recall of facts from memory. Example of questions, I can say, which city is the capital of China? Or I can say, when is the Republic Day celebrated in India? Different harvest festivals celebrated in the different states of India. I can frame a question under remembering the mind as define, name, identify, list, or state. These are some terms I can use it for framing a question under the domain remembering. You can ask a picture-based question and ask them to identify what they observed in the picture. This is a simple form of testing the learners under the remembering session. Next, it is understanding. So the different way of questioning or different way of framing question under the understanding domain is classify, describe, explain, summarize, and distinguish. The ability to comprehend or grasp the main intent of the material. It goes one step beyond simply remembering the material but requires a further description or explanation to demonstrate true conceptualization of the subject. An example of this type of domain, I can say, can you write in your own words? Who was the key character? What was the main idea? Or what is the moral of the story? Can you write a brief? Or can you write an outline of a story? So in all these ways, I can ask a question under the domain understanding. Next form of question is applying. It is the ability to use previously learned material and use it in novel situation in a form that is helpful to yourself and others. It goes deeper beyond the simple comprehension of the material to be able to apply it into a new form. Example of this type of domain is white milk is said to be a balanced diet. Why do you think the plants shrink when you cover the pot of the plant? So are the questions we ask for the learners to understand the concept and make them to apply their knowledge. Those type of questioning will come under the applying domain. A few form of sentence, I can say a few words which can be taken by teachers to frame the questions under applying is change, discover, modify, predict, solve. So all mathematical solution questions can come under the applying domain. Next, analyzing type of questions. It usually come for higher order of thinking skill. It require for this level because they not only necessitate the understanding of the content, but also the background of the fact. It can be like you teach a concept and ask them to think. Say for example, I explained them insoluble substances in water for class 6 science. In that I can ask them a question, why object float on the surface of water? Or I can say, what happens when the copper reacts with oxygen? And how does a rust form? So all these type of questions make them to analyze and understand a content and ask and help them to answer. So this is how the analyzing type of question is formed. Next question is evaluating. I can say evaluating. Evaluating is something you can use a term like a price, argue, assess, relate or value. Even value-based questions, you ask them to compare, you ask them to relate a situation to another situation and ask them to analyze and answer. So this you analyze, you ask them to evaluate, so you compare the questions and you test the learners. An example of this type of domain, an example of this question I can say, which of the diseases are related to coronavirus? Or I can ask them relate or write the diseases which is formed by the mosquitoes. So all these questions will ask them to evaluate. Even I can give you another example is under evaluation, under evaluate question, how would you determine the positive and negative impact of commercial properties on sanctuaries? So all these type of questioning will come under evaluating domain. The other type of questioning is creating. It is ability to put parts and pieces together to form a new whole. That is, creativity is highly sought after, sits atop on the list of levels which require higher order thinking due to the necessity to compile all previous knowledge in order to synthesize something that is all your own and novel to others. The questioning under creating is, I can say, as a range, categorize. So these are the different types of words that can frame a creating type of questions. I can ask them to design a model of breathing system or arrange the flashcards and according to the alphabets. Arrange the flashcards based on the category of vegetables and fruits, or ask them to develop a story, or compose an email, or categorize the different substances under the term solid. It is not that creating or analyzing, applying type of questions to be given more weightage, because it depends on the learners how the content is understand. Equally, you can split the marks and you can assess the learners accordingly. But we have to keep it in mind, this questions, whatever we ask, it should not be ambiguous. It should, and it also should be age appropriate. The age appropriate content and age appropriate questions can be taken for a question paper under the Bloom's taxonomy, so that the child have the efficient learning in each class, because education is the most powerful weapon which you can use to change the world. So it is always necessary that we have to be very conscious. It is always necessary that child has to understand all the concepts which is necessary and as per the content which is required. I have elaborately explained you the different types of questions under each domain of Bloom's taxonomy, and I hope this video has also helped you to an extent. Subscribe kindly. I request you all to subscribe to the channel if you have not yet subscribed to Bloom Skills, and motivate us to upload the further videos. And if you have any suggestions, you can type it in the comment box. You can type it in the comment box. And if you have not seen the previous Bloom's taxonomy video in the channel, I will also paste the link in the description box. You can check the link. You can check that video also. So thank you all and have a nice day.